Bitte beachten Sie das Rauchverbot in unseren Terminals. Das Rauchen ist nur in den ausgewiesenen Raucherbereichen gestattet. Vielen Dank.
Your attention, please. Please do not smoke in the terminal building. Smoking is only permitted in the specified smoking areas. Thank you.
Sayın yolcular, lütfen terminallerdeki sigara içme yasağına uyunuz. Sadece işaretlerle gösterilen bölümlerde sigara içilebilir. Teşekkürler.
Bitte beachten Sie das Rauchverbot in unseren Terminals. Das Rauchen ist nur in den ausgewiesenen Raucherbereichen gestattet. Vielen Dank.
Your attention, please. Please do not smoke in the terminal building. Smoking is only permitted in the specified smoking areas. Thank you.
Sayın yolcular, lütfen terminallerdeki sigara içme yasağına uyunuz. Sadece işaretlerle gösterilen bölümlerde sigara içilebilir. Teşekkürler.
Thank you. how's it going? And welcome to the stream. Today we are streaming some more Airport CEO. We streamed this game yesterday for about 5 hours. Super fun. I just bought it yesterday, actually, when we streamed it. So I'm still very new. We're still working through the tutorial. But I'm super excited. So we're going to play for a little bit more, keep working through the tutorial, and try and get like a functioning airport. So the airport that we started is EMI is the initials for it. It is East Municipal International Airport. I named it EMI because that's my cat's name, and I always name everything in my games after my cat, so that's why we did that. But we got pretty far. We have a pretty functioning, I would say, like, local airport going on. Let me get this here this way. No, let's do this way. So this is the road that comes in. And then you can come up here. This is where all the cars get dropped off. So we get bus drop off here, car passenger drop off. We got some taxis and we got some parking lots, which I added these since the last time that we played. And then over here we have all the construction stuff. And then we have the actual airport. So we come in here. These are the main entrances. We have the check-in. We have some information kiosks here, some waiting seats. Maybe someone's waiting to check in. We have some staff rooms here, some restrooms in the lobby. Then you can go up here, boop, and go through security, which I think we're going to upgrade in this live stream because it is a little bit slow if they need to, if a lot of people are coming through, like all these people are about to come through. But yeah, so they come through here. This is for staff security, so they don't have to wait in the long line. But yeah, but then you come up here, and it's very simple. We have three companies of flights, so we have Forest Air, Atom Air, and then we have Stripe Air. So these five small ones are for Forest Air, the three big ones are for Atom Air, and these three little ones are Stripe Air. But yeah, and then we just have really simple seats and things. Actually, these are all broken. I don't know how we get that repaired. Let's go to staff. Do we need to get janitors to fix that? I think so. So let's hire some janitors. Wait. Janitors. Let's just hire a few more janitors. Because we're actually at the point in the tutorial where we're going to start adding hire strategy. Yeah, we're going to start building some shops. So all these blank squares here are going to be different shops and restaurants and things like that. And I think also right now we are researching floor construction so that we can build a second floor because I want to build airport lounges, something like that. What are they called? Airline lounges, so that each of these airlines can have their own lounge. I think they're going to be like up above this area because we have this big open area where we can put some escalators. And then we can have the lounges so when people come in from their flight, if they have like a long layover, they can pay extra money and then they can stay. But right now we just have a lot of blank space. And here's where baggage claim eventually will be, and in here's where a lot of the baggage sorting is going to be before they go off to the plane. And I also think, oh wow. Hello Chase, welcome. upstairs is where we're gonna have a lot of the sorting. And then I think over here is where we're gonna have like the actual terminal for them to move them out to the cars. So right now what we're gonna do is just continue to work through the tutorial. I think eventually we are going to kind of just build like a whole new terminal and then eventually like tear this down. Because this is kind of small and we can't really expand anymore. I think eventually we will move like over here. But for now, this is our little regional airport. I think it's in technically New Bern is where I put it is in New Bern. So let's see, what do we need to do? We need to hire a security director. So let's go in here to staff, applicants. I think that's going to be in executives. Strategy director right here. Hire that one. Check. Now we need to unlock the shop upgrade and wait for it to complete. unlock the shop upgrade. So we're still waiting for this. So I'll fast forward the game a little bit because it is almost done. Oh, geez. Oh, yeah, and then I also got an auto planner. So now it's auto planning the flights. And ever since then, we are making a pretty substantial amount of money. It goes up and down in the red, but during the middle of the day, it is a pretty substantial amount of money that we have coming in. So we just need to wait for this, which we're at 75%. And then I think baggage claim will be next. Let's see. Drag out a shop room somewhere in your terminal. Place a shop counter. Click on the room to sign a contract. Okay. And then I also placed this weather thing down. Which... there's a lot of notifications. How do I turn off these notifications? Weather, because I want to turn off air traffic control notifications, passengers, staff, conveyor belt, vehicle, incident, and business. Other notifications do not display, I guess, because there's a lot with the weather. But yeah, I mean, it's working pretty well. I think sometimes it does bottleneck and the check-in gets a little bit throttled than the security. For the most part, everything's doing well. This is when it kind of dies down. In the middle of the day is when it's the most popular, obviously. Yeah, look, we're making good money off of these parking lots. But I do want to build, like, a very large... oh, it's raining. I want to build, like, a large parking lot area and all that stuff. Now, these chairs are still broken. How do I fix them? Let's see. How to repair gate seating. Airport CEO. But how? Yes. Gate seat's broken, how do I fix? Oh, nobody's responded. You need a technician to repair broken items. The technician. Get me out of here. Oh, look, we have... unlocked something. Oh, I think we have unlocked. Yes, all the floors and escalators and elevators as well. Uh-oh. It says there's no available check-in. But all of these check-ins are open. Oh, we have night flights? See, this is what it keeps doing, is putting all these flights at the very beginning of the day, and we just can't support that. Let's make this like a... let's do an hour between each. See, now it's gonna get bottlenecked because everybody's gonna start checking in. That's alright. It's working. I think we're gonna need to upgrade the security. Yeah, everybody's getting in, so that's fine. This is one of those airports where you need to get there 3 hours before your flight. So let's go back to staff. Need technicians. Service technician? Let's hire some service technicians. And they should come by bus or something. And we'll see if those things get repaired. Oh, here comes our first flight of the day. Nice. So many people get off. Wow, look at that. Okay, we're gonna need more stair trucks. So let's go to vehicles, purchase. Let's get two more of each. So that each of these big planes have a way of getting in and out. Because right now we just have this one. And these two need to deboard, so that's gonna delay it. But we have them both coming now. So here we go. We're gonna have a whole bunch of people getting out of these planes right now. Here they go. And then they are all gonna get bottlenecked at the way to get out of the airport. So let's go into research and development. And we need to research shop upgrade. Unlock the shop upgrade and wait for it to complete. I guess it's this. What are we gonna do next? Oh, conveyor belt system. That's gonna be chaos. That's when our airport is gonna go to shit. So now we'll just wait for that. See, right now we're making money when all these are full. So now we have multiple floors. We don't have lounges yet. Can we just go upstairs? Ooh, this is upstairs. I'm gonna go downstairs. So here, what is it that administrators? Hire more administrators so that we can get the development done quicker. Yes. And how do we get it to where we can do multiple things? I guess not. So we're gonna be doing some shops. We're not gonna worry about going upstairs just now. Because we're gonna lose a lot of money building a second floor. But I think we can start preparing for building a new airport. Because I think what I'm gonna do is split these roads off. You know, honestly, what we're probably going to end up doing is just completing the tutorial and then we'll start a whole new airport. Because I was thinking how it would be useful to separate out these this road here instead of having it one and having it doing a one-way system and then it connecting back up this way. So there's not all this confusion here. Halfway. So, because we're going to need to put large large planes in eventually. I think what we could do is attempt to move all of this kind of more down here, because eventually this terminal is gonna have to go down to be able to fit all these people. So I think what we're gonna do is get some more parking. One there and one there. Some sidewalks down there and down there. And I like to do all this construction at night. So then we're not like interfering with people. So let's deploy all of our contractors. So we'll do that. And then we'll have a public road. Actually, what we're gonna do is cancel all of this. And we're gonna put the public road there. And it's gonna be one way out of the airport. And this is gonna go one way this way. And then we're gonna have one way down that way. One way that way, rotate. So we'll have to like loop. Okay, so now we'll do that. Then let's get another public road. So we'll double this up. This will all be one way in. And then this will go up and over. That way we can have some decorative stuff. We'll have some sidewalks there. We'll need to get crosswalks there and there. Here they come. Okay, so this road we one way all the way down. And this will be one way this way as well. Exit, and then so this will all come down. Actually, let's extend this public road right there. Let's remove that. These will go this way. This public road will continue that way of sorts. And then we will have car drop off. Do all the way down this. Like that. And then we'll have taxi drop off. Actually, let's undo that car drop off. Yeah, so that's how people would drop all that off. And then we'll have taxis. Oh no, this is wrong. Demolish that. That was incorrect. Taxis. And then buses. public road. Do something like that. It's kind of annoying about all of this, so let's delete all that. And I want to try and get it a little bit more symmetrical. So car drop off. We'll start from down here and then taxi. One, two, three, four. So that should be the center. I'm just trying to get this centered. But for some reason it's not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So that's one in the middle. And 9 on each side, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that is the center. So this is centered. Oh, this isn't centered because there's no sidewalk on this side. That's annoying. So let's get some more car drop-offs. Put those here. And then we'll put a sidewalk down the middle. So people can crosswalk. Here. We'll do some bus shelters, the cheaper ones. Duplicate all of that. And then we can put some hedges. Awesome. We need to demolish all of that. Wait till they do that, and then we can put the public road in. Here. Interesting. So it doesn't look like we're going to be able to use. So let me just delete taxi, car, and bus. Okay, so they can, they just gotta do it weird. I don't know why they do it like that, but whatever, it's working. It's just very slow. So let's fix this head now that they're gone. I need to put lights. Grab these ones. So what I think I'm gonna do is demolish all of that, and then the public road is gonna go through here. And then we'll have the sidewalk. Go through here. And then we need the public road. There we go. It looks a little bit better. Now we need to fix the crosswalk. Get rid of these crosswalks here. And put them. Actually, I'm going to put the medium crosswalks. So all these people were stuck. Some more parking lots on the other side, because this is going to be the front of the airport. We're going to remove this terminal. So right here is where the entrance will be. So I want to try and duplicate all of this. All that did was the lights. Okay. So what we need to do first is sidewalk. We need to put sidewalk here, but not here, 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 and here, I think. And here. That should be it. And then parking lot. Public road. Go. Medium sidewalks. Oh. This has got to be two. Let's get all the one-way signs in. This is one-way. One-way. Something just happened. What are you doing? The hell was that? Okay. So we have tons of parking and drop off. And we can delete. We can delete this whole road right here. And then we just need to put sidewalk in so people can still get to the places. So let's just fill that in with sidewalk for now. Okay. And then we're going to need crosswalks here. And that, oh no, look at all these people trapped here. We need to put a sidewalk here. So you get back to the cars. Oh no. Okay, so we can remove. We can remove this sidewalk here and this sidewalk here. anything over here. We can delete all of this. We don't need any of that. Okay. Now what we can do... People are using it. I think over here is where we can have like our drop off and stuff. So let's see. Here we have constructor site. Because I'm going to want to build them a one way system as well with a little. So the center is, hold on, let's climb into the middle. Boom, 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 boom. This right here. How do I mark that so I'll remember? Let's put crosswalk. That's the center. If we go based off just that one, hold on. This one and this one. The center are these two. So yeah, there we go. Public road here and here. Something like that. And then you will have these. Yeah, they gotta go like that. So let's build... How do we build the actual terminal? So let's see. How big is this one? 8x3? So it's a 10x3. So if we do that, we'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Yes, so this public road, okay. So yeah. A public road needs to go like that. This needs to be a one way. Like that. And then if we build the terminal, we'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is how big it needs to be. 3x10. There we go. And then we'll have construction there and delivery site there. And then going here, floor, give it a nice floor. And door. We'll have a large door here. Have a large door there. A large door there. We'll have some windows. Yeah, we got some nice large windows there. That and we can do a medium window. Oh, I messed up. Let's do some medium windows along this. That'll work. And then we need to make this staff room. But this staff room is for contractors. Yes, there you guys go. So, staff room. Yes, let's get some walls. We're gonna make like an office. Put the desks down first. So actually they don't need desks. Sorry y'all. Yeah, they don't need desks. They just need a place to sit. So we'll do that, and then we'll do table here, small chairs here, and some plants. Oops, some plants here. Copy turn these around. Oh, I messed this whole thing up. Let me just delete all of it because I just messed the whole thing up. God dang it. So, couches. Here. Do that. Then we'll do this. And that. And that. And then we'll get some tables. T- tables like that. And then some chairs over there. Now we can try and duplicate this. See how much of it we can. So, not this. Okay, and then we'll get some single square plants. Those in. That works. We can get some of these big ones in. So whenever construction finishes, they'll all run in just like. Alright, and then there. Alright, I think that's pretty good. So they all have places. I mean, they don't ever sit, but we can just pretend that they do. And then we just need to decorate. What are these? A bottle, a pilot, an airplane, a tiny little statue. Let's fix up this. It needs to be on a sidewalk. Okay, so let's run a thin sidewalk around the outside of this, like that. And then we can run the hedges over that. Just follow the construction. We'll leave a hole, that way they can get out. Thank you. Okay, and then we'll put some flowers on the inside, white flowers. We just need some lights. Floodlights. Now we just wait for them all to get out. I'll put the last few hedges in. And then we can run some trees on this other side. You got a drunk chase on a Sunday afternoon? Bunch of trees in here. Nice. I deserve it. Yeah, definitely. So, there they go, back into the room, and they can take a break. So I'd say this construction is going pretty well. We do need to put lights on this. So let me get. I think this is the ones we used. No, we used the super expensive ones, of course. Yes. Okay. How do I do that? Just put one in the middle. All of this, I think it just does these lights. And then we can. Oops, we gotta do it like. Oh, that's annoying. This one has a. Space between it. That is very annoying. It's not symmetrical. Put this there. There. And then put some over here. There we go. All lit up. But yeah, no, we had a. So now we can delete all of this. Cancel the staff room. Here they all come. Is there not a way? Demolish that. Okay, there we go. Need to demolish that. now, this needs to connect up. For service road reasons. But then we can put a new checkpoint. Right here. And have a service road. It goes out the back. All right. Yeah, we're making good money from people parking in these lots. Oops, something is wrong. Oh, is it because they don't connect? I don't think there's any way to get them to connect. As long as they still work. Yeah, they still work. It's just because there's two different checkpoints that don't connect to the same area. But that's fine. So let's make this one way. It's going to cause a lot of mayhem, I think. Boink, boink, boink. So now they'll have to come down and around. Oops. Yeah, so this is looking good, I think. Let's look what we're supposed to do for the tutorial. Drag out a shop room somewhere in your terminal. I'm trying to think whether or not we want to do that. Because we're just going to destroy it, but I guess we should do it and work through most of the tutorial to try and get it. So now we're going to do some shops. So, shop room. Let's start with this one. Room position is not legal. Okay. It's gotta be inside. Can I not? Okay, so. Alright, place a shop counter and some shelves. Shop counter. And some shelves. Whoa. Got large shelves. Wall mounted. Basic. Nice. Pedestal, basic. So let me put a couple of these like that. Yeah, we can let it melt in. That works. So that's that nice little shop. Gotta wait for them to build it. Hey there, girl. Hope you're well. You've really expanded the terminal. Yeah, well, we haven't actually expanded this terminal. I've just added this where I want stores. But I haven't really done too much. We did add all this down here. I turned this way, we can see it. But like a huge parking lot, and then we moved all the construction stuff down here. See, they're all, they can take a break in there. And we had like moved all drop offs over here, parking lots and stuff. Because after we finish the tutorial, I'm going to attempt to build a new large airport, and it's going to be over here. much bigger, larger terminal, and then we'll have like all the check-in and everything over here, and then the terminal will go over and down. And then we'll have like large airplanes and everything. But right now, we are just working through the tutorial so I can make sure I have a hang on everything before we kind of just jump into it. Click on the room and sign a contract. So right now we're adding a store. Sign a contract. Ooh. Jewelers. Who's gonna buy from a jewelry store? Paper news. That sounds good. We need a few more shelves. 7, 8, 9. We need 2 more shelves. So let me go in here. How big is this? But I can't really see what it does. So I guess we can squeeze it into these corners. Wait for it to get built, then we can kind of see what exactly it's supposed to be. I don't like that people are walking through the store like that. But I guess that's the easiest way. Want them to come. Are they on their way to construction? These parking lots make us good money. It looks good. I took some inspiration from your decorative approach, by the way. Thank you. Yeah, these parking lots are basically money turners because everybody that sits in there, they have to pay the fee. So, I forget. Economy. Fees. So, parking, short-term and long-term. They pay $15 for short-term or $7 for long-term. So like each of these cars, I'm making about like $200 per hour that it turns, like each of these parking lots. It's pretty cool. At least for the ones that are short-term. For the ones that are long-term, I make a little bit more money. Okay, did they build those shelves? They did. So now we can go in here and we're gonna shine paper news. They say no. Why not? What do they need that we don't have? Oh, it's not big enough. Just barely not big enough. Quick stop. Power. Traveler stop. Let's do traveler stop. Okay. Wait for traveling passengers to make a purchase. Okay, so we need someone to work here. How do I know? Okay, these are backwards. So, can I delete these and replace them? Counters. Demolish the other one. Now we just gotta wait for the building. What have they got selling in here? Backpacks. Backpacks and suitcases. Well, nobody can make a purchase right now. Let's put some plants in here. We don't have any employees. I'm hoping that they are just on their way and going through security. Now, I thought I set this up to where staff is not allowed to use it. Staff has to use this one, but has to use it. Now, what type of staff employee works these? Like, what kind of staff do I need to work those? Service agent? Service technician? Operate security checkpoints, inspect bag, yeah, I know that. Franchise staff, operate stores and restaurants, provide. Okay, provide by franchises while there is an active franchise. Well, hate to break it to you, but that ain't working. So let's put another shop in here then. Paper plane needs nine shelves. Doesn't need a desk at all. What is that? Paper news. That's what I want. Yeah, paper news. We need nine shelves and a cashier desk. Very simple. And then we can decorate the crap out of it. There we go. Let me try canceling the contract and signing a new one. Let's do pick and fly. Is it open? So we have quite a lot of shelves. What time is it? It's 4 p.m. So that's like the main time of the airport. So I don't know why. They're there. There we go. Can I just slow it down? So now we got both stores open. This one's selling, I don't know, like a whole bunch of stuff. Headphones. Let's put one more store over here. Store there, and then those will be restaurants and cafes. I think this and this one will be a restaurant, and the rest of these will be cafes. Or we might be able to put another shop like here. Oh, not secure. Shop. Okay. So this one, we can do something tiny. So, well, this one's tiny. So this one just needs one shelf and a desk. Put that there, and we'll put shelves like that, and then we can just decorate the rest with plants. Put one there, put those there, maybe some in these corners. Nice. And then we can sign that contract. I think it was Turner. That'll all get built, and then over here, let's see, bottle. Yeah, bottles are gonna need 10 shelves and a desk. So we'll put the desk over here, and then we need 10 shelves. So seven, eight, nine. There we go. So that's another shop.
shops open. Waiting for somebody to make a purchase. Are they coming? Fast forward. Is that store? Did we sign a contract? I forget who we were gonna sign over here. But I know they needed 10 desks. Bottle? I wanna see him stock it. That thing looks really cool. With all the little things in there. What time is it? Oh, it's late. So these stores are closed now. I wonder when we get cafes. Traffic is a little bit. Oh, see, look, we just made like a whole bunch of money. I think we can send them home for now. I don't know how that's gonna sort itself out. Oh, there we go. See, I just needed to move a little bit. Just needed to break the game a little bit. Nobody has purchased a single thing from any of these stores. Alright, that store is open. Open, open, and open. station. Oh wow, look at that. Oh, awesome. Somebody bought something. Passengers have started to complain that they have to carry their baggage all the way to the aircraft. This is obviously not very efficient and greatly annoys our passengers. It's time to design a conveyor belt system so we can transport baggage to and from aircrafts using baggage trucks. To get a working baggage system and up and running, it's important to set it up properly. Can you continue the next checklist to get started? Okay. Complete the research and development project baggage handling. All right. All right, so now we're gonna do that. So this is where, probably the last thing that we're gonna need to learn. What else is there? Belt system. Baggage handling, conveyor belt, remote stands, and then large aircraft and passport controls. So after we build that, we'll be able to kind of start over here. None of this on this side is going to be symmetrical. So, like, this is going to be an odd number. When it should be 38. But because we didn't put a sidewalk in the middle here, messed up. So what we're gonna have to do is delete all this and move it over one square, which we're gonna do it. It's fine. We're making good money. So we need to deploy our construction. This. Remove all of these. And so let me just wait for them to get dropped off. And we'll delete all this. Thank you.
jeez.
Got a lot of traffic down here. And then we need to build a sidewalk in there. And then parking lot. Like that. A lot of traffic. It's these damn taxi drivers, man. They come in that way for some reason. Taxis. Let's just delete the taxis. And we'll just put cars there because the cars don't seem to have a problem. Hi, hello. How are you getting on with learning the game overall? Yeah, everything that I've learned so far, I've pretty much got it down, but there's still some things that I'm not sure how. Like, setting up the shops was confusing, but I think the reason it's flashing like this is because the stores are just opening. Yeah, they just now opened. But every now and then, like, the employees just leave, and I don't know why or how to do that, fix that or whatever. Let's check our research. Baggage handling. Still researching, it's gonna take some time. Okay, so now this is gonna go there. And service road is gonna go there. Where Where's all of our construction guys? What are they doing? Whoa, they all went up here? Is there something wrong with this one? Did I mess up that room somehow? Oh, it's not a room anymore. Staff room. Constructor. Dang. Oh, I've experienced that too. I think it might be a bug, so nothing you're doing wrong. Okay, that's good then. But no, it's mostly fun. What's annoying is it feels like you'll never get everything as symmetrical as you want it to be. And that stresses me out. Let's put some car stops. Ugh. Gotta delete all this. So I can put the car stops in. Look at some of these cars are like parked right on top of each other. I don't know what you're doing. Status roaming. You looking for parking? There's parking down here. There they all go. I think we're gonna get rid of these plants. Just so they have more space. Because now they don't have anything. Windows in. There we go. They don't ever sit down in the chairs too, which is kind of weird. So now we can do is put some trees in here instead of those plants. I like that the trees grow automatically too. I forget what game it is, you have to plant them and they grow. Here we go. Little decorative back there. We can spruce this up a little bit. Can I build a wall? Do something like that, and then cancel that, and then put in some floor. Put in some doors. Why does it always do this? It won't let me pick the small door. Do that. Windows. We'll do some small windows.
playing any other games like this? No, not like off of this. The games that I play the most are what is it called? Zoo Type? No, Planet Zoo and Planet Coaster is my most popular games to play. Those are my favorite games to play. I just haven't been motivated to really play them lately. I play Minecraft sometimes, so I like the grid-based games like this. Minecraft, Sims, games like that. Oh, thank you for the follow! Is it Star Kid Pep? Thank you. But yeah, no, I like grid-based games like this, but this is the first kind of, like, overview, like, what is it, Eagle Eye style of game that I've played in a while. There's another game I like to play called The Movies. It's a very old game. Like, this game gives me that, like vintage kind of game vibes, which is what I really like about it. Now, here's a question that I have. Am I able to make staff rooms, like... It's like, it doesn't let me do that. So I just gotta make it a staff area. Yeah, I'll just do that. I'm just making it look like a little building for this, to kind of square it off. You might like Overcrowd. I like games like this. Got hooked on Prison Architect a few years ago and can't believe it. And I can't just... Yeah, I watched people play Prison Architect. The first one that I saw like this was... the Academy one, Academia, I think is how you pronounce it, and then this one that I saw, Prison Architect, because I mostly watched like Conflict Nerd play it online, and then I watched a little bit of Flabaliki play it, and that's mostly what I did, but I never really bought it to play it myself. But then I was just like, screw it, I kind of got motivated, and I was just like, whatever, I'll just buy it and play it. Let's put some chairs down. I don't think anybody's actually going to use this building. But it's kind of just for show. There we go. Tables. And set. Yeah, I tried Academia, but there wasn't much to it when I last tried, but they seem to be doing quite a bit, so I'll give it another try. Yeah, because it says that all these games, I guess they're all by the same developer, it says that they're all still in beta mode, so that might be why. Because when I went to go purchase this, it said, do you want to buy the beta? And I was like, I didn't realize this was in beta. Because there's so much to it already, but I guess they're going to keep adding stuff to it, which is crazy to think about. We need to add lights over here. I like how after I place things, they go running out and get all ready to go. We need to place some sidewalk. But what I like about this game, too, is how slow the time is. Like, if I just press play, like, it's a very slow progression, which is something that I always hated about The Sims, was how fast the game goes. Like, it's like, you can play a whole week of the game in, like, 20 minutes if you really wanted to. But this one, if you really play it slow, it's a quite realistic timescape, if you will. I mean, it's a little fast. I've always liked those games that are, essentially, like, the real-time timer on it, like those games where you have to play it and then you essentially just gotta go to sleep and wake up the next morning to wait for them to finish researching something. But the time on this game is relatively slow and I enjoy that because I feel like I don't feel rushed to play the game. As opposed to like all those other games where it's like, you know, if, like in Planet Zoo, you'll be playing for like an hour and next thing you know you're on like year like 16.
I don't know, I just enjoy the slower progress of the game. Our parking lot's filled? Yeah, look at that. Here they go. I like when they go running out because it's so funny. Coming to destroy my flowers. Okay. And so, yeah, so like I said, like eventually rotate the screen this way. This is where the entrance will be. We'll have everything over here. And then it'll go, the terminal will go up and down. They're adding emergency services in the next update, so I think you'll have fire trucks and such. Oh my god. I don't know how I feel about this place setting on fire. Look at them all walking in the line. Like the, what are they called? The dwarves when they're all marching to work? It is so cute. That will be a nice addition. ATM is a bit sterile once you have something built. Oh, at the moment. I was like, ATM? It should add some variety of things. Yeah, I think that'd be kind of cool. Having like actual emergencies. Like, I think that'd be kind of cool. Like, because right now they have like weather and stuff implemented, like you can track the weather and stuff, but it doesn't really affect the flight, so I think that would be kind of cool where it's like, oh, you know, it's a cloudy day and then a flight fails to take off and people die, and then people don't want to come to your airport anymore because you have more dangerous, like, dangerous flights and stuff like that. I think that'd be kind of cool. Alright. So everything seems to be working. There's a little bit of traffic right now. But it's the end of the day, so all the flights are leaving. This is kind of cute. This is where they come and sit and have lunch. Okay. So now let's continue the tutorial. Extend your terminal and build a baggage bay. Baggage bay, this is where the cars actually drive and pick up the baggage, correct? Yeah, power issues. Yeah, because in Prison Architect they have like power and water supply and you have to maintain all that. That'd be kind of cool to add to this. And lights and things. So, suspend the terminal. I want to have the baggage bay. Baggage bay. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is where it goes onto. Oh, shit, this is huge. Cannot be placed on walls. Okay. So, if I place one there, I can place one there. So we need to get rid of the walls on the bottom. Which is essentially like a big warehouse. And then we can build these guys. Here. And here. Realized just realized that the taxiway is there, not the road. That's annoying. Grr. Let's cancel that for now. And then actually let's just cancel all of this. Can I cancel that? Let's start with the road, service road, here. And then terminal. We'll build it here. And then conveyor belt. What is this called? Baggage bay. Must be placed inside. Did I build the wrong thing? Terminal? Oh, I did. I don't know what I built. So then we'll get the baggage bay. And we'll put it in the middle. It's roughly in the middle. And then we can remove those walls. And then the service road. I think this will work. Connect the baggage bay to a service road. That is almost done. I think I need more supplies. Here they come. Now, why did this side not connect? Why did that side not connect like the other one did? Oh. Connect the baggage bay to a service room. I did. Is there something wrong? Baggage bay must be accessible by ramp agents. They can be placed in both secure and non-secure areas. But make sure that you provide a clear path leaving there so your employees can access it. Press B to show conveyor belt overlay. Why is it saying it's not? Something wrong? The service will be for the trucks, but your ramp agents need their own access. Yeah. But it says right here, connect baggage bay to a service road. And it looks just like the picture.
Is it because I need to connect all of these? Maybe I have to connect all the sides? Because the ramp agents can just come out. Oh, there's a gate here. There they are. Where are my little guys? Here they come. See if that makes a difference. Yeah, roads all over on the side should do it. Yeah. But it didn't show it in the picture. It's confusing. Can we just delete all these walls? Connect your check-in desk to the baggage bay with conveyor belts. Okay. So this is where I knew it was gonna get messy. So let's this service road needs to back up to there, and then do we have to like connect with the conveyor belt? Yes, escalator down. This one needs an escalator up. Okay. Then we need a conveyor belt. Actually, let me find where the hell these are gonna go. To my check-in. Do I have to have the medium check-in for that? Oh, I do. Okay. Can't deactivate a check-in desk with scheduled flights. Cancel the flight before attending.
Okay, so this is gonna take some time. Let's get rid of all of this. And then best to build your new desk first so you don't cause too many delays. I want to build the desk where this desk is. But I don't think we have many more flights for the rest of the day. Yeah. The morning is when it's super busy. About 2 hours. So the medium check-in desk is gonna go right here. Those conveyor belts are gonna go down here and here. Yeah, they put a lot in. You have to research bigger desks and things now. Yeah. Yeah. So this one's gotta go. But we have to wait until 4:40 for people to check in for that flight. Well, I guess they're gonna check in a little. Check in opens at 4:40. So let me just play fast forward. We're just gonna wait because most of those people are probably here. Oh wow, that plane just ran over the other plane. Okay, so now those went down. We need a conveyor belt. And that is gonna go this way. And then it needs to go pretty far. This one needs to go like that, and it needs to come to, oh, that flight is done, so we can close that and demolish that, and in the middle of the night we can demolish the other ones because we don't have flights in the evening. Like, does this have any more flights? Nope. And no. So we can close those and demolish all of this. There's no more flights for the rest of the evening. And then we can put our new medium check-ins right there. Gotta wait. Right there. And there any check-ins. And then we can put those conveyor elevators down. There we go. Oh, do they build those over the ground? Okay. We can slow the game down. There we go. So, now we have to build a baggage claim. That's where we're at. Build a baggage bay. So we have three flights, or three companies, so let's build three of them. So let's build... Let's see. How is this split up? So that's the middle. And then they can come out to here. Do that. I like the way they built it on here. Conveyor belt system. Go, and then we can have the up elevator. That all needs to come from this one. Now this up into these, and they spin around. So we need to make these baggage claim areas. Now do we do the whole thing, or do we do each one? Like, do we select which plane these are for? Or do we just do the whole room? You'll need tilt trays for it to go to all three areas. Oh, okay. And so we don't have those yet. How do we get those? I think it'll teach me some more. And then we have to unlock it or so. So for now, it's just gonna go to this middle one, and that's fine. Let's put a nicer floor in here. Let's put some tiles around. Ooh, these are fancy. Let's put some tiles around the baggage bay so that way they can keep it sanitized. I'll put some nice wood in the middle here. And then I guess we could put this nice wood all the way around. Like that. And then we can put those information boards. What was it? Yeah, these, in case people need. Like, maybe people are waiting in the baggage area to meet with somebody and they're trying to see when the flight has landed. Yeah, like that. And then we just need to put a bunch of chairs and stuff. The airport back home by me never had chairs by the, baggage bay. I remember it was always chaos. Oops. Dang it, I keep hitting the wrong button. Do it like that. And we'll leave that open for people to walk out. And then we need to put some plants. We can put some seating. No, we'll just do the seating. Along the back here. Like that. And then we can put little plants between. And that is our baggage bay. I make the area in the middle a staff zone too because people can walk over the belts. What? Okay. Staff zone. Why can people walk over the... I guess in the game mechanics they have to make them walk overable. Or else people are going to... Or unless the staff isn't going to be able to walk over it. Nice. Let's put some more plants in here. These ones. One here. And we can put three of those there. Bam. Nice. Decorative. Tons of seating. The airport has like a blue and red theme, huh? So, am I gonna go ahead and build? So, drag out a baggage claim area and build a conveyor belt around it and then open it. Oh, open! I like the way that room looks. Connect your check-in desks to the baggage bay. Connect your baggage bay. And connect to baggage bay. You could put more plants in there instead. Unfortunately, it's the only way to stop people from walking around there.
Yeah, I put some plants in there. I kind of want to change the floor. Change it to like this. So for us looking down on it, it looks like one of those full systems, you know, like we have in real life, where it's like kind of raised up. It's like metal and stuff, so we can pretend like it looks like that. Connect a stand to the baggage bay. So yeah, that is what we're gonna have to do eventually, is each airline is gonna have to have its own baggage bay. So that'll be fun. We'll have to connect the different check-in desks. Right now, let's just do the large ones so we don't overwhelm. Connect the baggage claim area to the baggage bay. How am I gonna remember how to do all this after this? Great! Make all objects are activated, and that we have some extra ramp agents. So is this activated? Open. Are these open? Open. 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 Open, open, open. Okay. No ramp agents. So I guess we need to hire some more. Because right now, I don't think we have that many ramp agents. Staff. Hire. You're good enough. We can train you up. Higher. I think we want one more. Yes. Okay. Aren't we going to need one of those cars? There you go. Operate the baggage handling. Purchase 2 baggage trucks from purchasing vehicle. Vehicles, purchase. Large. Ooh, one has a roof and one doesn't. Large pull force baggage, large one with a roof. You used to work as a ramp agent. Well, I can see why you would like this job then. I mean, this game. I guess we'll get one with a roof and one without a roof. Ramp agents handle everything related to baggage and will work both at stands and baggage bays. Okay. So it is 5 a.m. on a Friday, so it looks like today, our flights today are going to have baggage. It's snowing. It's not snowing, it's winter. So our flights today, wow, look at that. Cool. So here come our flights. They're all gonna have our baggage done today. Something's wrong. Oh, there's no baggage. Something's wrong. He's got a symbol on his head.
She's out here freaking out. She can't get in here.
Karen, what's wrong? Oh, it's because her bone's in here. Did you enable the baggage on the airport screen? Did you enable baggage on the airport screen? Oh, no, we didn't. Is that gonna fix that? Activate the baggage bay. Uh-oh. We have to connect everything to the baggage bay? Alright.
Can I connect baggage while handling a flight? Oh man, I didn't know that. I thought we could just do like only certain flights are allowed baggage. So yeah, we activated it, but it's still saying no, and it looks like the symbol is saying that the path is incorrect. So let's go down. Oh yeah, look at all these. These things are like backwards and inside out. Oh my god. So let's delete that one and that one. This goes. Yeah, look, some of them are backwards. Then it goes this way. That's all right. Yeah, that's all good. Then it goes down and out. This one comes out. Ooh, that's all good. That's all correct. And then it goes up. Yeah, so some of these weren't correct. I don't know what happened. We just gotta wait for our guys to come delete these and rebuild them, which is inconvenient because now we're not gonna be able to do. We're not gonna be able to do fucking baggage. Oh, you'll need more check-in desks to handle so many stands. Yeah. Look. Oh my god, now they're all stuck. We gotta hurry up and get them built. Yeah, I'm thinking. So we're not gonna have to use any of that for the baggage. Because originally I thought this was gonna be completely inside. So I think what we're gonna do is extend. That we'll extend our check-in area and add like a whole bunch more so let's do that. Did they fix those? Okay, so now everything looks like it's heading in the right way, but it's still saying. Let's see if we can follow. Ah! Now we gotta wait for somebody to build that. Trial and error, trial and error. Yeah, we're gonna need more check-in desks. So let's have somebody come and build that. Sure that all these are correct. Where is our construction guys? There he is. So bam. We can slow the game down. And we can follow him now. All of these bags. They should make their way all the way to the baggage bay. Everyone's gonna start getting delayed. Oh, I gotta close this door.
No respect for gaming.
Head away.
There we go. So, I guess we don't have enough ramp agents. I don't know what is on the TV, but those speakers sound epic. Yeah, my boyfriend's playing Death Stranding right now. And he's got it cast into the TV, and it's like super loud. God damn it. Do you need... Okay. I think the ones we need to connect... No, you are connected. You are connected. You are connected. These three need to be connected to baggage bay. Oh, something just happened. He's gonna pick up those bags. No, he didn't. He's gonna drop off bags. Why don't we have any ramp agents? I hired a whole bunch. Yeah, look at all these. Oh, Jesus Christ. Look at all these ramp agents that we have. Standing still, working. Activity, empty. Activity, standing still. Why are they standing still instead of working? If I click, will it show me where they are? I'll hire some more, I guess. Did I assign them to the baggage bay? How do I assign them to the baggage bay? Okay, I just assigned some to the baggage bay. How many ramp agents do we have all together? 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. Okay, so we need to put 5 on each side. We'll have the 3 drive the cars. There we go. Back to work. They should be arriving. Oh, there we got one. Ramp agent? Yeah. Let's follow. Follow you. Can you, like, just pause for a moment so I can... There we go. They are going to this plane. Well, that's a big message. There's a tab somewhere for jobs that should show how many staff of each kind you have and how many jobs there are and how many jobs are queued. They should give you an idea of what staff you need and what you have too many of. There's a similar thing for vehicles. Alright. Staff. Shifts. Statistics? Staff statistics? Activity. They are extremely productive, I'll tell you that. Job tasks. Can you get out of here? Dang it. Job tasks and every 10 minutes. So they're doing a pretty substantial amount of work. Oh, it looks like baggage is doing better. 45 baggage. Yeah, look at that. We're getting a whole bunch of baggage done. But it still has no people over here. Shouldn't they be standing on the sides? Okay. They've changed things around, so I can't help, but I know it's there somewhere, but not sure where. So this guy is tired. He's a ramp agent. But he has that flashing gears above his head. So what does that mean? Does anybody know what that means? Let's see. Airport CEO gears in thought bubble. New thinking bubble? What does it mean? Okay. Problem symbols. Don't know what that symbol means. Let's Google it. Ramp agents. Not working. Won't load and unload bags. All the connections set, but nobody is loading or unloading. I'm having the same issues. Thanks. I hate when people say that, like you're not helping. Have you set the number of ramp agents to the cargo bay yet? Yes. Station ramp agents per side is 5. By the rate of engines. Ramp agents busy doing other tasks, and are they able to access the cargo bay? Check the zoning! The zoning! God, it's the zoning! It's the zoning, because it's not staff and it's not secure. Staff and secure. And then we need to make this. Then they can come out of here and walk down. It's the zoning. So everything's connected, but they're not in the proper zoning. So let's see if now that the zones are there, they can get to it. Yeah, look, he's running. Look. Look! They're going! Okay, I'm gonna eat some Cheetos. Just let me know if they're too loud. At least there's no major delays yet. Can I connect these yet? Look at them all. They're doing it. Can we connect you? Oh, yes. So everything should be connected to the baggage bay. The baggage bay is now in a secure zone, so they are unloading baggage. Look at it all! And it's going to the baggage bay, which has happened. Oops. So all these people are waiting for their baggage. It's gonna come out of the middle here. And all that baggage is gonna get get picked up and brought. Oh, that's saying there's no path. But I think it's because we don't have the tilt tray. Here they come. Here comes your baggage, everyone. Collect your things. Now what happens if this baggage gets too full? God, what if there's too many bags on there? You know what I mean? Is collection open? I believe so. Looks like people are grabbing their bags. This bag is- okay. Yeah. It's working! It's working! They're all grabbing their things. And are people checking in? Are you bringing the bags? Goodness. He's bringing the baggage to the little plane. I feel like a ramp agent would be a really stressful job. Like running around shit. Big ass planes driving around. People's stuff. Alright, it's working. I don't know what all those people up there are doing. I guess they're waiting on their bags. Alright. What is this tutorial on? Handle baggage successfully on 5 commercial flights. So now I'm just gonna go and wait. To work. What does it mean by handle baggage? Does that mean take baggage or put baggage back on completely? There are some bags there. That's a ramp agent. He's in the conveyor belt. It's not the easiest or best job in the world. Fast paced and stressful. Yeah, I'd be stressed the fuck out. Especially at like an international airport. You'd have like 60 flights an hour going through. Bing, bing, fucking throwing luggage. Let's go! Gotta read those little papers like super quick. There is some traffic, dude. Look at this. Oh, why are these people dressed the same as all the staff in those stores that just closed? If someone leaves their luggage on there and like never collects it. And do they have people that come by and they're like, oh, and just take it? Are y'all waiting? That's your bag. Go collect it. All these people's bags are on. On this conveyor belt, but they're not collecting them. I'm confused. We work in teams of 3 or 4 and to turn around a flight in 40 minutes. We once did 120 bags off in the same back. Yeah. I'd be too physically exhausted. I'm a little bitch. I'd be like, it's on, I'm tired. Oh look, they're loading bags on. Do ramp agents also do the little flashlight thing where they're like, alright, you're good to go. Back up. This poor guy. Loving this whole plane by himself. Now I said 5 ramp agents per side. That doesn't look like what's happening. Working. So they're all working. And we still don't have enough ramp agents per side. So I'm gonna hire a few more. Sorry, you're not good enough. Because that poor man was working all by himself. Aren't collecting your baggage. I might have to Google it. Let's Google. Let's see. Guests not collecting baggage. Oh, airport CEO. Let's see. Yep, not claiming bags and stuck for no reason. Is this an old game that you just dug up? No, actually, this is airport CEO, and it is in beta mode, and it is constantly being updated. See what this says. So my pat. Oh, they're moving now. Let's see what this said. Why they were doing that. Same issue. Screenshots. Packs. I don't know. They said they don't know. Sort of. Although we were a small airport, we didn't have those. But you do walk out into the taxi. Oh my god, I'm choking on Cheetos. I feel like it would be so loud. Whose bag is this? Yours, sir. Get off. Alright. We have successfully taken it and cleared out baggage today. I think. Let's expand our check-in desk area. A little bit. So I think what we're gonna do we're gonna need 3 check-ins, I think. Can I say what this is connected to? No. Because can't you connect the check-in? So, we'll have to get 3 check-in desks. Check-in desk medium. the queues go all the way down. Information boards. Perfect. Can we place these conveyor belts down? Yeah. Ooh, we can't. So let's actually move the desks up one. Up there. Actually, let's try and... We can't line it up with that. How annoying is that? So we'll put one there, one there, one there, and one there. Then we'll go to the conveyor belt. Down. Put them all in here. And then we will do a conveyor belt that goes along this way. And then you can just go down like that. Yeah, that's just gonna be the easiest way, I think. And then we can just get rid of these. So let's wait till those are built and then we'll get rid of them. We can get rid of all of that. Let's get some plants in here. And are our guys coming? Yeah, where they come. They are working. And we can put this on fast forward. Because no one really comes into the airport at night. Awesome. Close out for now. While we upgrade all this. So let's build a queue. Whoa. Build a queue. Okay, and then we can destroy Okay, I hope you have a good night, and I'm glad you found your channel. Looking forward to seeing the next one. Alright, yeah, I don't know when I'm going to be streaming next, because this week I'm kind of packing up my house and getting ready to move, but, yeah, the stream munchies are real. but just keep an eye on my Twitter, and I'll try and post on there regularly when I'm going to go live. Like I said, when I get back to school, it's going to be kind of busy, because they're changing the way the semester's working with COVID, so instead of being a 16-week semester, it's two separate 8-week semesters, and then they split my classes in half, and each semester, half of them are online, half of them are seated. So, it's like, I have the same amount of classes I was going to have, but now I have to do some of them in 8 weeks, and having to take physics and calculus in an 8-week period is going to be a little bit stressful. So, I don't know if I'm going to be able to stream that much, but I don't have any classes or work or anything on Fridays, so if I do stream, it'll be on Fridays. So just keep posted on the Twitter, and I'll let you guys know when I'm going to be going live with that. But yeah, I'm having fun playing this game. Oh, he threw in some luggage. So what kind of people work a passenger service agent. So we need to hire. Are you? So we have four of them that work here. So we need to hire four more. Staff hiring. Passenger service agent. We need 1, 2, 3. We can hire you. 4. That should be enough. Good luck with moon and school. Thank you. So now we are kind of in the plight of the day. A bunch of our flights come in first thing in the morning. We are making money. It's slowly rising. Let's see, what does this want us to do? Okay, so this is fantastic. You are now on... Now, from now on, passengers should no longer have to carry their baggage with them. However, it seems that suspicious content could be let through and loaded onto the aircraft. This is, of course, not a regulation with modern air travel safety standards. Let's build some scanners so that you can sort out the baggage with proficient or prohibited content. Baggage security tier 1. Baggage security tier 1. What's that? Music is lit. So this is gonna take 12 hours. So let's get ahead and start it on that. What are these guys doing? A little bit better. We might need more trucks. Connect to a baggage bay. So let's connect these all to... What did I just do? Connect these to the baggage bay. Bam, bam. Those are connected. So these do have some flights scheduled for check-in. Okay, let's clean up this place a little bit and add some like hedges and things. Do that, and then we can add those nice big ones that I like. Great. Not valid. Never mind. We can't do that. What we can do is these hedges can come all the way up to here. Like that. And then what we can do is delete these. Put the hedges there. Yeah. Okay, are these done? Close. Close. Alright, let's delete these. Why can't I delete that? It's closed. Can't remove a check-in desk that is with an active check-in procedure. Alright. Not yet. Let's fast forward a little bit. And then
demolish that. So the guests will check in and exit down that way. Think. Yeah, see, they'll go around that way now. I guess. Look at this. Is he running? 6:30 a.m. So it seems the baggage bay's working. Waiting for this to complete. It's only at 19%. I'm gonna keep it in fast forward for now. Just so we can get that researched pretty fast. How are these check-in desks doing? Can we... Tons of people running all over the place. We use these bathrooms? Oh, look, they're loading baggage. I think the only two that we have left, so this is for scanning. This is remote stands, and then large aircrafts. So we're almost done. I want to get the scanning done tonight before we finish the live stream, and then we can do remote stands and large aircrafts tomorrow. Or whenever I stream. Let's put some sidewalk here. Let me see how big the terminal is going to be. 38. So... Oops. I don't want that. Damn it. We want 19. That is the middle, right where that crosswalk is. So I'm thinking, I'm gonna have to plan this whole thing out. I kind of wanted something like this. This goes in a little bit. So this is the center. That's where the doors are gonna be. And then I wanna have this go down a little bit. Kinda like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 already uneven. Okay. Something like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, get rid of that light pole. We just need to delete some walls now. Check-ins there. Okay. It wants to build a generic conveyor belt scanner. So let's go down. Can I close this yet? And destroy it? Nice. So I guess we'll build that, like, right here. Bag destroyer and baggage scanner. So I guess we're going to take out a loan, which I've managed to get this far without having to. Wow, these are nice loans. So, we need this needs to go here. Thank you. this way and up through here. And then you're gonna go through this. Like that. If it's fine, it's gonna go back down. Gonna go this way. And then if it is flagged, it's gonna go into the bag destroyer, which we should put it over here, because we are gonna need to add a whole bunch of other things eventually. I do know that. So we'll do that. So that's gonna put a bit of a delay in our baggaging. So I'm just gonna speed things up so the construction guys get to work. And here they come. They're gonna be putting a whole bunch of bags in here. They're just gonna be dropped off there, but they are coming with the new stuff right now. And 50 bags. We've already scanned 23. Last one, okay, and we are back up and running. Wow, we are destroying a lot of destroying like every other bag. Oh my god! Stop! These people don't even know! Almost done. There's just one more thing to learn. Remote stands. Okay, yeah, so this is where we're gonna stop today. I'm gonna start researching it, but this is where we're gonna stop the live stream today. We're gonna do remote stands. And, what's the other one? Remote stands and large aircrafts and passport stuff. We're gonna do all that in the next live stream. We're gonna go ahead and call it a quits today. We're not making money right now, but we are. So these check-in desks, we're gonna have them here. We're gonna have a lot more flights, and then we can also have some small check-in here for some smaller stands.
we're going to have an intricate. So that's how that will be. And then let's get some nice hardwood floor. We'll get some nice big windows as well. Large windows. Is that the middle there?
Yeah.
So we'll put them in the middle. And we'll put some smaller windows on the sides. So that one doesn't go there. Let's see if the medium ones will fit. Medium, medium, and medium. We need to put the wall back up here. Sidewalk here and in here. I'm gonna put seating and stuff on the outside there. So if like, oh, there's a fly. So if you would have just gone back from your flight, like you're waiting for your ride, but you've already gotten all your bags and stuff, so you want to wait outside. And then you can sit out there. Check-in so far. And then we'll pretty much go straight into security from there, I think. Because I don't want to set these queues up right now. Yeah, so I think we are good for today. They want us to start the research and development for that, which, yep, it has started, but we're not going to get to that today. I'm actually going to go ahead and end up the live stream, just because it's about 3.5 hours, so I think that's a good stopping point here today. So like I said, I don't know when I will be streaming just because my schedule is kind of up in the air right now. I'm hoping to stream a few more times before I have to go back to school on the 1st, because I have about 4 more days until I have to move. So I have to finish final exam paper for my summer classes, I have to pack up and get ready to move, and then I have to actually move, so I don't know. And then I don't know what my streaming schedule will be, unfortunately, because of the fall, because of the way the scheduling is going this fall. It's a little bit hectic and kind of stressful, so for the first few weeks of school, I'm probably not going to stream, just so that I can get settled. But I don't have classes on Friday, so if I do stream, it'll be on Fridays. So hopefully we'll play more of this game. But yeah, like I said, so just keep a post on my Twitter, which I have linked up here. And that way, you always know my streaming schedule and when I'm going live and stuff like that, because I try and post on there more regularly. And if you want to just follow me personally to see what I'm doing, watch me move into school, get acclimated in my new classes, then you can follow me on Snapchat or Instagram. I don't post as much on Instagram unless I do something big, like this trip that I just took recently. But you can follow my Instagram and my Snapchat to see what I'm doing. But yeah, I hope to see you guys at the next live stream. Thank you guys for stopping by. We are 4 subscribers away, or 4 followers away from hitting the summer goal for me, which is 130. So let your friends know that I'm playing Airport CEO if they like it, or if you know somebody who might like it. So I hope to see you and everybody else at the next stream, whenever it is. Thank you guys for stopping by. Bye!